Hi, Jamie Pennebaker here. This is a continuation of our Luke tutorials. This one is on analyzing text files. Let's start off with a demonstration of inaugural speeches given by every president from George Washington to Trump. And this one is his very first one. We're just going to analyze George Washington's very first inaugural address. We'll go into Luke. It opens. We go to analyze text. Okay, we specify a text file because we're going to analyze a text file. We identify the one we want to analyze, click it, and ta-da, there it is. We've completely analyzed the first inaugural address in history, and you'll see it has 1,420 words, and there's about 80 different dimensions of Luke that it's analyzed along. And let's save this in an Excel spreadsheet, which will allow us to open it and work with it in different ways. And what we'll see is it looks pretty much just like what we've just seen. And there we have all the information in terms of the various Luke dimensions. Now, after looking at this, what I'd like to show you is that we can do the same thing. Ooh, wait, what just happened? So we just saw that text was selected. Then we use the Luke processor to count words, compare words in the text with those in its internal dictionary, and it calculated the percentage and built the output. So here is George's inaugural address. If we count all the words, there are 1,420. And now the computer will go through looking for articles. We're just going to use articles as an example, A, N, and the, and it goes through and it looks at for every instance of A, N, and the, and what it calculates is overall there are 132 articles divided by 1,420 words, which in other words, 9.72% of all of George Washington's inaugural addresses were articles. And here's the output. We see that 13% of all of his words were pronouns, 18% were prepositions, etc. And you can see how intuitive this is, that we're getting percentages of total words for most of the dimensions that we're looking at. Okay, let's stand back, and instead of looking at an individual file, let's say I want to analyze all of those files. We go into the directory, highlight all of them, push open, and now it runs all 58 files. And this is pretty impressive. We're going through all 58 files in probably about 8 seconds. And what you see are all of these columns, and you see every president on the left, and all their dimensions along all the across Luke. And again, we can save this in Excel spreadsheet. We can immediately do a mean, standard deviations, etc. Now, I want to do one more example of this. It's kind of boring because it's the same idea. But instead of going into a directory and highlighting all of the files, we can actually analyze this at the folder level. So this time, we're just going to click on the folder, the individual text folder. Do you want to include subfolders? Yes. It goes through, analyzes everything in that directory and the subdirectories, and we get the exact same results we got last time. Pretty slick, eh? Now, the last one we're going to do is going to be looking at an Excel spreadsheet initially. In other words, very often we have text that's in a spreadsheet that includes both the text and other data. Look at this. This is the inaugural addresses Excel file, and what you see is it has the president's name, which term it was he Republican or Democrat, the year he was inaugurated, how old he was, and then column H is the actual text. Now, what we want to do is analyze this text that's in there, but keep the other data intact. And we'll click on inaugural address. We open it, and then it says, oh, here's column H. That's the one we want to analyze for text. So we click on that, and by the way, we don't want to do the first line because that's just the title of the variable. Analyze it. And within a copy of that same spreadsheet, what we find is we keep the information on the left, the file name, the party, et cetera, but then here are all the Luke variables to the right, which means we can essentially analyze our data as soon as we do Luke. Now I'm going to do one final issue, open this in an Excel spreadsheet, clean it up just a little bit so that you can appreciate one minor problem. You'll see that line 1 and 2 are mixed, are a little bit messy. So the old file, we're going to copy those file names, put them on the top file like that, and then get rid of the second line. Voila, a perfect file, ready for analysis, ready for you to become rich and famous. That's it for now. Thanks a lot.